So the actual wall construction that we use is we use 2x6 studs that allow us to get more insulation into the wall cavity. Then we have plywood sheathing. Then there's a continuous air moisture barrier that runs from the foundation of the home up to the very peak of the roof itself. And then there's 4 inches of Polyiso signed-rate sheathing. Insulation on the exterior of the home. The advantage of that is that not only does it add to the insulation within the cavity itself, but it insulates the framing. So we've done away with, eliminated the thermal bridging. The actual ceiling is insulated to an R75 level, which is more than twice what a typical home is ever being insulated to. But it's not in the form of insulation in the ceiling. Is actually built into the roof structure itself. So if you went up to the roof, if we were in the attic looking up, you'd see the space between the rafters is insulated, and then there's a plywood insulating foam composite assembly that's built up for the roof. So the combination of the insulation between the rafters and the foam built up roof gives us that R75. And one of the advantages of that is that this attic now is considered part of the conditioned space, so that there's very limited ductwork up there, but if any of it loses heat, it's still within the boundary of the building envelope itself. All of the ductwork in the home, if you look up, you'll notice it's all has masted, it was taped and sealed to ensure that it was airtight.
A vinyl-covered wood?
Yeah, vinyl-covered wood. Yeah. There are two panes of glass. There's a thin, transparent film between the two panes of glass, and they're filled with a low conductivity gas.
Gotcha.